So we're at the final stage of our basic lighting circuit. We've extended it from one way onto two way, and now finally onto two way and intermediate. And as before, we're going to carry out the continuity of CPC test and polarity. We're going to follow it off by the insulation resistance, and then our circuit is going to go live, and we're going to do some basic live testing, recheck polarity, does it work, and functional testing, do the switches open and close the circuit. So before we start, we've got to do the continuity of CPC test, set the instrument up as we've stated previously. So I've set it onto the ohm scale, which on the Megger MFT is in the orange scale, and we're going to need to remove the resistance of our link. So we've stated this in previous video presentations. I'm going to link together the crocodile clips, which are in the red and green sections in the top of the instrument we've talked about before. The instrument automatically starts, so we're reading an ohm reading now. Press the test button. Still got a reading, press the test button again, and we've now gone to zero. Remember, if it's flashing zero, it's below zero. It needs to press the test button at least one more time. So we're going to link together now in the consumer's unit the line, conductor, and the earth bar to pick up the CPC. So we're linking together the line and the earth bar, and we're going to go and test at the furthest point on circuit, which, believe it or not, is the lighting point. Just to remind you, the line conductor comes through into the loop, comes down on our twin brown, and then works its way through the switching line conductors, depending on which configuration we're in, until it returns back to the lighting point, making the maximum amount of cable being at the lighting point, and it is the furthest point on circuit. However, we record the highest reading wherever we achieve it, and we should see when testing at the lighting point that our reading will change depending on how much of the switching circuit we have in. So we only need to make a mental note of the highest reading at that lighting point before we drop down to do continuity at the switch, middle switch, and last switch. So we're going to do the continuity CPC at the light fitting as usual, checking polarity at the same time, does it come on and off. Remember the highest reading, drop down to each switch in turn. Again, remember the highest reading and record whichever reading that is under our box heading R1 plus R2. R1 representing the resistance of the line conductor, R2 representing the resistance of the CPC. If it does come on and off as we go through the switching sequence, we can also tick the polarity box, and then we can move on to our insulation resistance test once the covers have been reinstalled. So let's get on with the continuity of CPC and polarity combined test next. So we're going to connect on to our earth terminal, which is securing into position our circuit protective conductors. And we are going on to the switching line within the actual band lamp holder. We discussed previously why we're not coming in here. We've only been here 7 weeks. So I'm onto my switching line within my baton lamp holder. I'm currently in the on position with a reading of 0.54 of an ohm. I hopefully can turn it off now. So I'm gone greater than the scale, so we've got full scale deflection. If we turn it back on, I've now got slightly less at 0.51. Back on. Now we've got 0.55 and then off again. So I've run through from first switch through and then back again. I don't operate each switch in turn. You turn one off or on, whichever way it is, and go to the next switch and back again. I need to leave the circuit in the on position. So let's turn it on at any switch. And our reading is the highest one we've achieved of 0.56. And we've proved that these switches turn on and off the light fitting itself. So therefore we've proved polarity, but we've still got to prove continuity of CPC at each individual switch. And whichever reading we get, wherever it is, we will record the highest one. So we've got about 0.55 of an ohm as our highest reading. Let's do it at each switch in turn next. So I drop down to my first switch, and I just need to pick up a line conductor and the earth terminal where the CPC is connected. And I've got a reading of 0.29 of an ohm, which is lower than the reading I achieved above. So we now move to the second switch. So we come to the second switch, which is our intermediate switch. We're going to pick up the line connection and a connection for the CPC, and we've got a reading of, settles down, 0.23 of an ohm, which is lower than the reading we achieved at the lighting point. We move to the last switch, which is a two-way switch. Again, we pick up a line and the CPC, and we get a reading of 0.27 of ohm. So we have achieved the highest reading in circuit at the lighting point. We've proved polarity by operating the switches and leaving them in the on position. We're now ready to move on to our insulation resistance test once we've put all the covers back on and ensured that all loads are removed. So let's do that next. So we've completed our continuity of CPC and polarity test. we're ready to move on now to our insulation resistance test. As stated before, we need to turn our instrument into the Megger ohm scale and set it to 500 volts DC. We've also inserted, as before, our leads into the green and red sections of our Megger MFT. Once again, we could have used the blue lead, but we've chosen to use the red and green lead. We're going to short the leads together to ensure that we have continuity of those leads, so we should get a dead short on the insulation resistance test. We have, proving that the leads themselves, as I said, they can snap here without actually seeing them physically snap. They can come disconnected there. So we've proved we have continuity of our leads by shorting them together, and we're ready almost to start our insulation resistance test. We must ensure that our switches have been left on. We did during the continuity test, and we've got, in this case, they're all down. That doesn't need to be for two-way and intermediate, the down throw to be on. They could be in any combination of up and down, but we've left them on during the continuity test. We must remove all loads, so the lamp itself needs to be removed before we start the test, and also any sensitive electronic devices. In this case, we've got the RCCB. We must ensure that that is in the off position, and we must ensure the circuit breaker is also off, because we've said before the test doesn't know it needs to go out and do the circuit and actually pass it back through the circuit breaker and across the bottom of the RCCB. So the supply is isolated. We're ready to do the insulation resistance test, so let's move on to that test. So there's no particular order in which we did the test, so I'm going to clip on first of all onto my earth bar, and I'm going to test between that and the top of the circuit breaker, trying to keep my arms out of the way, and press the test button. And we've got a reading of greater than 999 megohms, so off the scale of the machine. I'm going to go across and do between the earth and neutral bars, press and test and hold it on. Greater than 999 megohms. Now I'm going to go between my neutral and my top of my circuit breaker for the line, so neutral and line. Once again, I've got a reading greater than 999 megohms. We expect the overall insulation resistance of our consumer unit, that's all the circuits, to give us a reading greater than 1 megohm. Further investigation is required where the reading falls below 2. Brand new installation with only one circuit, we expect it to have a fantastic reading for insulation resistance. We don't expect the insulation to have deteriorated through time, through age, through sunlight, so UV degradation, and perhaps it's been in connected to something very hot. We don't expect it to have broken down over time. We've got a brand new installation. Our insulation resistance should be fantastically high, somewhere in the hundreds of megohms. However, the test is not complete because our installation has two-way and two-way and intermediate switching. So we've got to walk back into the installation now and throw once again both two-way switches into the opposite on position in order that we test the other part of the strapper. So let's do that next. So we're not quite complete our insulation resistance test yet. We need to walk into the installation and find our two-way switches and throw them back into the opposite on position in order that we get the other strapper in circuit, and then do the insulation resistance test for that circuit again. So as we come into our installation, we've got a two-way switch, intermediate, and a two-way switch. It is only the two-way switches that need to be thrown into the opposite on position. It wouldn't matter how many intermediate switches I had, we'd leave those alone. We just throw the two-way. So I turn it off here and back on here. And now I can go back to my consumer's unit and for that circuit, repeat the insulation resistance test again. So we come back to the consumer unit after throwing our two-way switches into the other on position, positioning the strapper in circuit. And again, I'll go onto the earth bar on top of the line, press and hold my instrument. Reading greater than 999 megohms. Onto my neutral bar, so earth and neutral bar, press and hold the test button, a reading greater than 999 megohms, and then move across. I'll do between the neutral and line, press and hold. I've got a reading greater than 999 megohms. I've now completed the insulation resistance test because I've done it in both on positions. If I had 10, 20, 100 intermediate switches, it's still just the two-way switches that are thrown into the opposite on position in order that we get the other strapper in circuit and complete the insulation resistance test. So now we've completed the continuity CPC and polarity test. We've done the insulation resistance test twice, did it in the first on position. We walked out into the installation through both two-way switches and then repeated the insulation resistance test again. We're now at the point where we're going to go live. We only do very basic live testing. We check it works again, and we're calling that recheck in polarity. Does the light come on and off? I'll show that in another video presentation. And prove the functionality of the switches. Do these switches actually turn on and off the light fitting? And have we got the ability that the glorified switch, which is the RCCB, operates from on to off, and our circuit breaker also will open and close the circuit itself, seeing it go on and off. So they're glorified switches in the consumer unit, and we'll pick that up on functional testing. I hope this video has been some help.